Chelsea Handler, welcome to the Daily Social Distancing Show.
Hi, Trevor. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic. Thank you very much. How are you doing? I feel like you have been on quite a journey over the last few years. I know we spoke about some of the things you experienced in your book, but your new stand-up special is out, and it has been 6 years since you were last on the stage. So how are you, and why now?
I feel like I wanted to bring some relief, you know, to this time that we're all stuck in between the pandemic and this administration. I really felt compelled to like figure out a way to shoot this stand-up special during COVID, and going home to New Jersey just seemed kind of apropos of everything in the special I'm talking about. And it was just for me a big reminder of humanity and the fact that we're all kind of struggling together, and not to forget that. And to remind people, like, hey, there is laughter in pain and, you know, all of that good stuff. So it was meaningful to me to shoot it during COVID and to, you know, and to run the show during COVID and practice the sets and all of that stuff, and to give and to bring everybody together for a night for many people who had not been out since COVID started. So
I've always loved how you put your specials together, you know, whether it's traveling to Africa and then coming back with a different perspective on life, or doing all the drugs in the world and then doing a special about that experience.
Drugs are always a theme in all of my specials and all of my work.
But the why of this was really interesting to me, because it has been 6 years since you were last on the stage doing a show like this. And I wanted to know why. I'm always intrigued by why someone comes back when they come back.
I didn't really feel like I had anything to say in the stand-up medium. I think I was just exhausted by doing all of my shows and my books and my touring, that I didn't feel like I was making a contribution, you know? And when I took a step back after leaving my Netflix show a few years ago and really sat and thought and went to therapy and thought about my privilege and thought about the contribution I wanted to make rather than the taking and the cashing of checks and all of that, and being a loudmouth, you know, just that. It was like, well, what am I really going to do? What am I here to say? And who am I here to be an ally to? All of those things started to, you know, marinate in a different way for me. And I stopped spinning eight plates at the same time and was able to focus on one thing at a time, you know, whether it be my book or my documentary or this special evolution. The integrity changes when you are focusing on one thing. So the deeper I can get, the better off, you know, and the more I can impart and hopefully help and touch people, you know, in ways I hadn't before.
What I love about the special is how you talk about therapy. What are some of the biggest things you learned about yourself in therapy that have now changed how Chelsea Handler approaches the world?
Well, first of all, I got the gift of self-awareness, which is, you know, invaluable, to find out that I've been behaving like a bitch for so many years without even thinking about it. I was like, oh, I'm just here to tell people the truth. And it's like, well, not everybody needs to hear it from me or is interested in hearing it from me. So it was very revelatory, A, to find that out about myself, to find out that I had, you know, delayed grief about something that happened as a little girl, and that I had a trauma that, you know, moving to LA, you live in this world where everyone wants to talk about trauma and triggers and manifestation and kale. And eventually, you know, you fall into it and you end up at a silent retreat, you know, sipping kale juice with explosive diarrhea going, how did I get here too? But it's true, you know, it helps to go to therapy and talk with somebody about your problems. And it's the most humiliating experience. And that's why I had to share it, because like you find out things about yourself that you're too embarrassed to even say out loud.
Like, right.
And you have to admit all of your shortcomings, you know, you have to admit your impatience. The fact that, you know, I can't even stand in line at a Hudson Booksellers at the airport because the slowness of the transaction annoys me. It's too slow. You know, I mean, going over all of these things with a therapist and then being like, so what do you think I have, ADD? And they're like, no, it's a little bit more serious than that. In my case, it was that I lacked empathy, you know? And for me, I was like, it was like a light bulb. Once that went off and I realized he was telling me the truth and I realized I did lack empathy, I was like, oh, okay, I'm here to stay. Give me the information and, you know, go back. And then once I realized, you know, everything's funny, you know, if you're a comedian, everything's funny, even death is funny. So you just need time to just kind of, you know, put it into your storytelling, whatever your specialty is. Mm-hmm. And so I was really excited to share this with everybody and just kind of really show myself in a way that I hadn't been seen before either. It wasn't scary. It was like, it was new and exciting.
Yeah, it also felt a lot more vulnerable than we used to. I mean, it's a special way you talk about death in your family, about, you know, your father dealing with your brother's passing. You talk about the pain that you experience. You share a lot in a way that is very vulnerable, and it feels very different for us to see with you. Even you talking about not drinking as much, you know, which is very funny, but also really honest in the way that you were telling the story. Did you enjoy being that vulnerable? Because I mean, like, as a comedian, you always have this shield, you know, but it felt like you had a few cracks in the shield and you allowed people to peer in further than they have before. Was that a little frightening for you?
You know, it was hard, you know, as a comedian, it's hard to be in on stage and not hear laughter. So when I showed that show, you know, this special, when I showed it to my agents and I said, hey, I think I have a special ready, and they came to see it, you know, my one agent was like, you have to sit with the serious moment longer and let it breathe. And I'm like, I can't. I'm allergic to not having that, that instant gratification
right.
that comedians are used to. You know, that's what makes Chappelle so genius. And he doesn't feel the need to go after for the laughs. He's provoking your thoughts. And so it's really hard. I mean, it was hard for me in that sense to really stick to the moment and let the moment breathe when I do talk about my brother, because, you know, it is emotional. And, you know, you don't get emotional every time, but when you're really present with something, then it shows up in your work, you know. And it was a great lesson in how to be diligent and be focused, you know, be focused through the beginning of a set and then taking it all the way to filming the special. And to be present and not to be drunk or wasted, you know, you can be a little stoned now. That's my thing. But you know, the other stuff is like, oh, that's old me. You know, there's like a new thing happening. So it's fun to share it with people, but it's definitely no. I like to walk through challenges. I love to be different. You know, I love to show something different when I'm feeling something different.
Although you have always been someone who is crazy and loud and funny and just like doesn't take anything seriously, you've always been really engaged in politics. One of the more interesting political discussions you've gotten into recently was between yourself and 50 Cent. You guys have had an interesting relationship over the past few years, and the latest update that I've seen is 50 Cent said he will be voting for Trump because despite him not doing well with black people or not being great for black people, 50 doesn't want to pay as many taxes. You then stepped in and said, I'll pay your taxes if you vote for Joe Biden. And then you said, and maybe I'll even have sex with you. I mean, you alluded to it. And then 50 came back and responded and said, all right, I'm voting for Biden. I mean, this seems like allyship on the next level is what you've done here, Chelsea Handler.
Well, first, let me say something. I spoke to 50 Cent last night on the telephone, and I'm going to tell you all about it. But first, I want to apologize for having to say I was reminding him that he was a black man. That's inappropriate. And I think as an ally, I need to set an example by always apologizing when I make a misstep. And that was a misstep, that I'm a white woman saying that to a black man. That's not cool. So I apologize to everyone who was offended by that. I will say that if any of my ex-boyfriends come out in support of a white supremacist president that we have, I am going to call them out on it. So he and I did have a conversation last night on the phone for about, I don't know, 25 minutes, 30 minutes. I just wanted to make sure, I wanted to talk to him about what he tweeted and to see if he was serious, because sometimes he tweets things that aren't serious, as do I. And he's not. He's supporting Biden. So, you know, he was just kind of pissed about the taxes, and we were joking about that. But I, you know, we talked about like taxes are, you know, when you make a lot of money, you have a bigger responsibility. That's what society is. And by the way, if you want to evade your taxes, Republicans have a whole handbook about how to do that. And there are many states you can live in to do just that. So it was a very healthy conversation. I did get the impression that he did ask me about taking a little spin, as I paraphrased it. I said I would be interested in taking another spin because you can't legally pay somebody to vote for someone. So I am open to figuring out another form of payment for him, but he's already a Biden supporter, so I don't really even have to do that, go down that road.
Well, I can safely say that if more politics was engaged with in the way that you have engaged with it, politics would not only be a lot healthier, but a lot more interesting. Chelsea, thank you so much for joining me on the show. Congratulations on your new special, and also I think your new place in life. It's wonderful to see you.
Oh, thanks, Trevor. It's always great to see you. Thank you.